attention. We are nearly halfway through the series.
Good afternoon, Passbeam. Today I'm working from home, mixing some music and also editing the first of a much longer interview video that will go up just before one of your episodes, like an extra bonus episode.
I'm losing all sense of time and reality. Mandy, how are you feeling?
I'm good, I'm just...
Please speak into the microphone.
I'm finishing up a client project while we're looking this bad.
Excellent. Mandy. Let's go to town.
If I can't film it, did it even really happen, Mandy?
Am I a puppet to you? Am I your goddamn puppet?
Where was I a year ago? Probably underneath Bing's bed in a plastic bag. You know he talks to himself when he's masturbating?
It tried to snow last night. It hasn't stayed.
Let's address the elephant in the room, okay? I look very stupid.
Mandy still doesn't have a house.
Yep, we're gonna try and figure something out.
It's becoming a bit of a problem.
Hey look, it's 2017, and Mandy's playing Pokemon Go.
It's gotten good again though. No one can take it. Someone beat it just before a raid started. And so they couldn't put their shit in it.
I've been feeling old lately, Passbeam. And not like in my body.
Homewares. Oh, goodness me. Oh, I love kitchen things. Look at this. Who needs this? No one but me. Oh, pastry brush. I need a pastry brush.
And not like in that way, because I've always liked boring stuff. I mean, for the first time, I'm really feeling a generational gap. I work with young people and I work in a very youthful industry. I'm thankful that the kinds of things that I do keep me in the orbits of young, creative, interesting people. But lately, I have been noticing that I have less and less in common with people who are 18. And I've also personally been wrestling with my worldview, my ethics, my morals, my political outlook. Let's tick off what we already know, shall we? I'm a humanist. That means I appreciate and see the value and virtue in human action, human agency. I'm an atheist. That's not a secret. I don't believe in a higher power, the existence of a soul, the existence of ghosts. Furthermore, I don't believe that we need it. I think, and this goes back to the humanism, we can do okay on our own. I like to describe myself as a pragmatist, someone who takes practical considerations into account just as much, or maybe sometimes more, than ethical or moral ones. Someone who believes in the merit of a problem-solving, proactive, hands-on approach to life. I'm not a nihilist, but there is a certain meaninglessness to everything that I find kind of enjoyable. Politically, I'm fairly left-wing. I'm at least very socially liberal. I believe in freedom and equality. The rights of marginalized groups. I advocate as much as I can as a straight white man for people of color and LGBTQ communities. But then we start getting into the shifting sands, right? There's this old adage that as you get older, you get more conservative. And I think that's happening to some degree to me. For instance, whether I agreed with it or not, I've always taken part in capitalism. But over the last year or so, I've actually put time into trying to understand it. I've acquired this nasty little habit of seeing both sides and playing devil's advocate. A lot of people find it very frustrating. I'll be at a party and someone standing next to me will be like, hey, yeah, you know the American industrial medicine complex? I wish I could tear that down. And I'll be that guy no one likes who turns around and starts talking about how we really benefit from that. Someone will be like, I hate Trident. I wish people would stop parking their nukes off the side of Scotland. And I'll be like, okay, but have you read a book about nuclear deterrence? Do you know the history of nuclear deterrence? Do you understand the purpose of nuclear deterrence? I'm getting to a point where I'm seeing that gap in understanding, that gap in inquisition. And maybe it's the arts world, and maybe it's the community that I'm a part of, which is historically always going to be very left and liberal. But I feel like I'm just slowly, glacially edging towards the center.
I like avocado toast as much as the next guy, but kids these days don't know anything about money.
I'm also feeling the cultural divide more and more, and it's not just so-and-so trend, so-and-so meme on Twitter makes no sense to me. Whole schools of behavior, whole attitudes towards technology and towards purchasing and consumerism, the relationship that teenagers now have with social media, from the point of view of someone who remembers a time before social media, it seems so ludicrous and disgusting and toxic to me. And the kinds of discourse I see online, it's like a pendulum. I'm constantly swinging between being really impressed and really, like, worried about the future.
Kids these days have so many feelings. You're valid. I see you. Oh, I appreciate you. Come on! Where's the blood?
I'm not sure if I'm making any sense, to be honest, but I wanted to try and approach the subject because it's been on my mind lately.
Them young'uns don't understand the hardships we went through with the recession, the Great Recession of 2009.
Well, yeah, they don't understand. What else don't you like about young people?
I think they're doing some pretty cool stuff. You know, they're saying that the amount of old people who have now died and the amount of young people who have now become eligible voters would change the entire Brexit vote if it happened again. That Norwegian girl who's pushing for climate change at the summit. I think there's some pretty cool stuff going on. Some pretty active young people out there.
I'm feeling disconnected from my peers.
Younger than you, because a lot of your friends are younger than you. Yeah, think about that.